Let's speak now to basketball analyst Mikey Reyes for his thoughts on the continuing dominance of the Red Lions and if there's a team that has a chance at dethroning them. What do you think, Mikey?
Hi, Mitch. Good evening. We'll see, but right now the San Beda Red Lions have been really on a tear, and I don't think there's the way Coach Boyd has been handling them the past few seasons, there's really no complacency and no overconfidence in the Red Lions.
Now, Mikey, you mentioned about their dominance, of course, in the first round and today. You know, with this balanced team, how were they able to do it, and why are they, you know, doing it on a consistent basis?
Well, it's really the mentality that they have. Even though they lost superstars in Robert Bolick and JV Mokon, you know, the mentality coming into this season that they're ready to mature. I mean, they had one whole offseason wherein the Bandana brothers, who didn't get much minutes last season, were tasked to really lead a team already from a second stringer, even a third stringer in Evanelli. I mean, for you to come out and, you know, be a starter and shine in that role, it really speaks of the offseason and the preparation of this team. And then you consider the balance of this team and the depth of this team. The third stringers, or maybe the second stringers, can actually be starters in other teams. So it's really the, you know, how deep of the roster is really deep that you really don't know who's going to explode on any given night.
Now, besides with what you mentioned, now, Mikey, I'm going to take you back in time when you were playing, of course, with the La Salle Green Hills when you were in high school. And, of course, nakasabay mo tong mga to, coming into college with the UP Fighting Maroons also. Yeah. And now that you're a broadcaster, can you tell the difference of this San Beda team compared to the past years, at least from what you've experienced?
Well, from what I've experienced, though, the one thing that hasn't changed is their dominance in the NCAA. Because after that, it was only in season 91 that they were actually dethroned. So really, the program, it speaks a lot about the program of the San Beda Red Lions, even though, you know, they've changed coaches the past years. When I was playing, it was Coach Frank Lim, and then for a while, it was Coach Demai Karin, and then it's Coach Boyd. It's really the program. It's not just, you know, the quality of players that they get year in, year out, and the ability to get these players and recruit these players. And I think also the alumni, the help from the school, and the support that the students and the teachers and the staff give them. It's really, you know, the difference really is the changing of the game. Well, it's basketball in general, because before it was more inside, the way Sam Ector was, and then Sudan Daniel came in, and then those guys. But now, you know, a lot more shooters from the outside, and then point guards, you know, the long line of point guards. So I think the difference is the changing of the game, but the similarities, you know, they're still winning in the NCAA. So still exciting basketball from the San Beda Red Lions.
Mikey, who have been emerging as the best players so far? You know, besides, it's a given, Kwekute, Nelly, Oftana also, but what about for the other teams?
So for the other teams, obviously, Jeric Balanza has been hot lately, leading the league in points per game. And then earlier, you talked about the Marcelino twins. Aline Bulanadi has been helping San Sebastian out, because San Sebastian started out slow to start the season, and they were actually on the bottom half of the standings. But since Aline Bulanadi took over, he finished the first round in second place in terms of scoring, only second to Jeric Balanza. San Sebastian has found their, you know, their groove, and they're back on track. While the CSB Blazers have been struggling, but, you know, you can expect the CSB Blazers to still compete in the second round for a Final Four spot. But right now, it's really four teams vying for three spots in the Final Four, considering San Beda is really, like, on top already.
Well, at the end of the first round, it was these guys, LP, Letran, CSB, and San Sebastian, the teams that you mentioned, were tied at 6-3. Ngayon, abante na ang Letran and LPU for second place. But these four teams, you know, what have they been doing right? At least, you know, something that they have in common. That's why they're up there in that middle of the pack.
Well, honestly, they're getting wins. They're taking care of business every time they go up against the lower-tier teams. Talking about Mapua, Perpetual, JRU, Arellano, and EAC. Every time you go up against these teams, you have to take care of business. You cannot lose against these teams if you want to compete with the teams above you. And that's what San Sebastian was failing to do. They lost a couple of games that they should have won to start the season. But that big overtime win against Letran gave them the confidence, and then, you know, they just steamrolled during the latter portion of the first round. But really, that's just what they have to do. They have to take care of business when they go up against the lower tier teams. When they go up against San Beda, they have to compete, and malay mo makabulag sila. And then when they go up against themselves, that's when the, you know, that's when the games get crucial, because it's usually one over the winner over the other when entering the final four.
Well, Perpetual and Mapua both at 3-6. Do you think, Mikey, did the records do justice with the way they're playing? Why can't they close out games when the opportunity is there?
Well, for Mapua, they're rebuilding right now, especially with Coach Randy Alcantara at the helm for his first season. They're somewhat rebuilding. I mean, this isn't the roster yet of Coach Randy. I'm sure Coach Randy has players in his, you know, in his team B, or, you know, ready to come in for Mapua next season when his actual roster comes in. But for a team that no one really expected for Mapua, I think Mapua has been playing pretty well, especially now tied in sixth place. But for Perpetual, I know they lost their reigning MVP, Prince Aziz, but I didn't expect them to fall this low in the standings, especially with the entry of Benedict Adamos from San Beda. So I was expecting Perpetual to be a little higher. I mean, even though they lost Prince Aziz, but for Mapua, I think they're doing a good job with this first season of Coach Randy Alcantara. It's really the development of the players that's important for season 95 for Mapua.
Mikey, to whom are you most impressed, at least maybe a couple of players, at least in the first round?
Honestly, you obviously you talk about San Beda, Lyceum, Letran, San Sebastian, and St. Benilde. We also talked about Mapua and Perpetual. But for me, what's been impressive is JRU, because this team was predicted to be winless coming into the season because they lost Jed Mendoza. They didn't coming into the season. We thought MJ De La Virgen was gonna have a big role in the team. Barba also, but then Bordon. So these three players, I mean, they're gone now. They're not playing. So they were actually expected to go winless. But Coach Luis Gonzalez has really put in that mentality with the kids. I always call them the kids of JRU. Talk about Ajay Miranda. Ajay Miranda was actually in our top 10 with scoring. He was actually number 5 in scoring and during the first round. And then you add up all the pieces. You have the big guys down low who are really competing in the interior, even against foreign athletes. And then you have the outside. And that's really the effort of the kids and the youth that are, you know, the development of these kids. They're 3-6 right now, but they can be really scary in the coming years.
Lastly, Mikey, are we going to see a separation early in the second round? Do you think that more or less can LPU, Letran, at least, you know, separate themselves amongst the pack that are, you know, inching closer?
Well, it'll be tough to tell, because like what we said, the four teams are vying for 3 Final Four spots. But I have a feeling that these guys will go neck to neck for the whole second round, because, you know, every time they go up against the team underneath. And I think that's going to be the biggest development. If one of the teams from the bottom half can beat one of the teams who are vying for a Final Four spot, because those losses will be crucial for them. But I believe, you know, with the experience of LPU, even though they don't have CJ Perez, the system is still there. They still can lean on Mike Harry Zuzu, especially during crunch time. And then the experience of the Marcelino twins, Yael Ray Marcaduya. So I think the experience of LPU and Letran, like what you said, can be crucial entering the second round. So for me, the final four spot will be competed by San Sebastian and St. Benilde, just because of the lack of experience when it comes to those crucial games. But, you know, it's going to be a toss-up between these four teams, so I can't really say. And it's going to be a chess match for these coaches, because, you know, the line of coaches from these four teams, Coach Topic, Coach Louis, and Coach Bonnie, Coach Egay, and Coach T.Y. Tang. It's going to be a chess match between these four teams for the final 3 spots, considering San Beda makes it already.
Quickly, Mikey, just a quick follow-up. Who was the MVP for you in the first round?
Well, the MVP for me, considering obviously 9-0 on San Beda, I'm going to have to get it from San Beda. It's either I'm going to have to go with Calvin Ostana, versatile forward. He can really do it all for Coach Boyet. And Evan Ali, because, you know, he's also doing it all for San Beda. He's passed to the team. left behind by none other than Robert Bolick. So big shoes to fill. But for a second year guard, he has really been doing well in that new role that he has. But he's used to it. I mean, he was the star player, a top point guard from the Red Cubs in high school. So for me, these two have been the most consistent guys for Sandeta. So,
all right.
We'll see who wins MVP. We'll see.
All right, so there you have it. Mikey Reyes, SNA analyst. Thank you so much, Mike, for joining us here on the show.